My research focuses on a special type of fossil, which are called bromolite, and these are fossilized digested remains. The most common type of fossilized digested remains are coprolite, which are basically fossilized feces. And luckily, one coprolite was found in the Bromacker locality. Thanks to 3D imaging techniques, we will be able to digitally explore and then learn more about the different bones that will be present inside and the different animals that were eaten by a predator.
Hast du dich schon mal gefragt, woher wir kommen und wohin das Leben sich entwickelt? Das Museum für Naturkunde Berlin hat die Antworten. Wir erfinden uns neu und gehen mit dir in die Zukunft. Werde Teil unserer Museumsevolution.
Die Bromacker Fundstelle ist etwa 290 Millionen Jahre alt. Das ist im unteren Perm, im späten Paläozoikum, das ist das Erdaltertum. Es ist wirklich eine unfassbar spannende Zeit hier, weil wir genau diesen Übergang vom Wasser ans Land haben. Wir haben die Verantwortung, dort weiter zu forschen, damit wir über diese frühe Evolution der Landwirbeltiere und auch über den Ursprung unserer Ökosysteme so viel wie möglich erfahren.
A super great discovery that was made recently was this specimen right here. So this one is not a coprolite. Indeed, our ongoing study suggests that this is a regurgitalite, which means a fossilized regurgitation. And thanks to the 3D scans, we were able to identify different types of animal in this small cluster, which means that different animals were eaten by the same apex predator. One particular challenge about trace fossil study in general, and bromolites included, is to identify the producer to the trace. So how do we do this? Well, what we do is we have a look at the morphology, have a look at the size, have a look also at the content of it, so we can know if it's a herbivorous animal or a carnivorous animal that made it. And then we compare that with the known paleofauna from the locality. We do not see the bones on the surface, so these are inside. So the only way to tell what animals are preserved inside was to basically destroy it by making thin sections and then having a look under the microscope. So it's a super good way to do that. It gives us really good results, but in the end, the specimen is destroyed. Here with 3D modeling, we are able to study in three dimensions all of the content of these specimens without destroying them, so that we can still, after the study, show that to people, show that to the public and say, look at these. Inside of that, we have all of these bones and they can have a look at the specimen and take it in their hands, which is for me like magical. Here we have the two-dimensional scan. It is only one slice of the whole specimen, and we can see, for example, here a rounded element with a white outline. So this, for example, is a bone, and what segmentation is that I'm going to take sort of a brush and I will go over this shape, such as this, yep, and then I'm going to go to the next slice and do the same thing, and then over and over again. And there are almost 3,000 slices. So thankfully, the bones do not take all of the 3,000 slices. They take maybe 100 or something like this. So on this specimen, I would say that in total, this took me about maybe 25, 30 hours, something around this. So this can be quite time consuming indeed. And here you can see all of the different bones that are present. Also part of the job to identify which animals are there. This is still an ongoing work, but so far we believe that there are at least three different animals present in there. We collaborate all together to have the best idea as possible about from which animal does this bone come from and from which animal does this job come from. So it is all of a teamwork. So about the predator, based on the overall size and the morphology and the fact that there are different animals inside, we believe that this was an apex predator, so a predator that was at the top of the food chain. And most likely this was an opportunistic animal, so it was kind of feeding on everything it could find. From the Bromacher locality, two main candidates could be chosen, maybe Dimetrodon teutonis or Tombacarnifex encephalcatus, which could be two potential producers of this regurgitolite right here.
Unser Ziel ist, das gesamte Ökosystem zu rekonstruieren. Wie viele Tiere dort waren, mit relativen Häufigkeiten, wie jetzt die Nahrungspyramide oder Struktur war, Nahrungsnetzwerke, wer hat wen gefressen und derartige Sachen. Und jedes Fossil ist im Prinzip ein Puzzlestück, was zum Gesamtbild beiträgt.